Hello and welcome to EEcraft. Let me introduce a simple but elegant application of the Wi-Fi capable Nano ESP32 microcontroller board. To accomplish this project, you will need the following parts: a Nano ESP32 board, a 16x2 LCD display, and optionally a breadboard for convenient electrical connections between these two components. In this video, we will cover the following topics. 1. Setting up the Nano ESP32 board with the Arduino IDE. 2. Configuring the onboard Wi-Fi of the Nano ESP32 board to connect to the Wi-Fi router for internet access. 3. Utilizing the Network Time Protocol, NTP, to obtain accurate time information and displaying the date and time on an LCD display. The ESP32 Nano board featured in this video is manufactured by Waveshare. This board is fully compatible with the Arduino ecosystem and is identified as a Nano ESP32 board by Arduino. It boasts the same I/O pinout as the Arduino Nano ESP32-S3 board and other boards in the Arduino Nano series. The major components on board ESP32-S3 Nano are shown here. It has a power indicator LED and a user-configurable LED. The main component is the dual-core ESP32-S3R8 processor that can run at 240 MHz. The board also has an RGB LED, 16 MB flash memory chip. The board is capable of communicating wirelessly using 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi and Bluetooth LE. The ceramic antenna is visible on the board. The ESP32 Nano board can be powered and programmed using a USB Type-C connector. To use the ESP32 Nano board with the Arduino IDE, we need to install the Arduino ESP32 boards package from the board menu. Once the package is installed, the ESP32 Nano board will be detected as an Arduino Nano ESP32 board. In order to connect to the internet and retrieve time information from the NTP server, we need to utilize the Wi-Fi library, along with the VIA library for I2C and the RGB LCD library for the Grove 16x2 LCD display. In lines 16 and 17, the login credentials for the Wi-Fi router are given. In lines 22 and 23 of the sketch, the NTP server addresses are defined. The pool.ntp.org project is a large virtual cluster of time servers that provide reliable and easy-to-use NTP service for millions of clients. The ESP32 Nano board will access this server tuple time data. It is actually pool.ntp.org, let me correct it. Alternatively, we can use different NTP servers like time.nist.org, which maintains Coordinated Universal Time, UTC, and is hosted by government bodies in the US. The next line defines the UTC offset, which specifies the time difference from time at 0 degrees longitude in seconds. The next constant defines if the daylight saving is enabled. The spinner function displays a rotating leaf on the LCD screen while waiting for the Wi-Fi connection to be established. The print local time function retrieves the current time from the NTP server, formats it, and prints it to the LCD screen. This function is called from the loop function. The get local time function, which is called in this function, is defined in the library that comes with the Arduino ESP32 board installation. In the setup function, all the one-time settings are configured. This includes initializing the serial port, initializing the LCD display, setting the cursor to the first character on the first row. Additionally, the Wi-Fi is initialized and a connection is established using the SSID and passwords defined earlier in the sketch. Till the Wi-Fi connection is established, the spinner function is called. Once the connection is established, the connected message is displayed along with the IP address. After connecting the ESP32 to the network, we utilize the config time function to set up the NTP client and retrieve the date and time from the NTP server. You may note that the server addresses, UTC offset, and daylight saving settings defined in the beginning of the sketch are passed into this function. The loop function is very small. It just calls the print local time function every 250 milliseconds. Well, we are now ready to upload the sketch into the ESP32 Nano board. I've just hit the upload button. You might notice that the display on the small screen already shows the time, as I tested this code before. However, I wanted to show what appears on the screen once the sketch is uploaded to the ESP32 Nano board. While it compiles the code, let me explain how it works. The ESP32 Nano board acts as a client by connecting to the NTP server, which is set as pool.ntp.org using the user Betagram protocol, UDP, on port 123. The client sends a request packet to the NTP server, which then responds with a timestamp packet. The ESP32 Nano then extracts the current date and time from the response. To display the date and time on the LCD, you can refer to a video posted on this channel demonstrating how to display data on a Grove RGB LCD. The link to the video is provided in the description box. If you are interested in learning more about Coordinated Universal Time, UTC, you can find additional information in the Wikipedia link provided in the description box. In essence, UTC serves as the primary global time standard for coordinating clocks and time. It is based on International Atomic Time, which is derived from a weighted average of numerous atomic clocks around the world. The compilation is completed and the sketch is uploaded. You might have noticed the display just before the connection was established. After the connection to the NTP server, the date and time is displayed. Note that we have utilized the worldwide NTP server pool.ntp.org. If you wish to ensure connection to a server closer to your region, use the corresponding addresses as indicated for the respective regions. Feel free to explore and experiment with this at your discretion. Consider trying a different type of display to add more creativity and fun. This project will also run on batteries. The clock does not need to be adjusted when the battery is changed. It will always show the current date and time information once it is powered up and connected. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe to support eCraft.